Hi ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to my channel. Do you know how to draw and name all the possible isomers for C5H10? If you know the 10 isomers, then you are welcome to skip. If not, just join my class. In this video, I'm going to show you how to draw all the possible isomers for the formula C5H10. C5H10 applies the general formula of CnH2n, which can be an alkene or it can be something else, which I'm going to explain in a while. And let's start by drawing the straight chain 5 carbon atoms alkene with a double bond at the first carbon. By the way, you will find many links in the description showing you how to differentiate between branched and straight alkanes, and also how to name alkanes, and different organic compounds. Here we have 5 carbon atoms alkene with a double bond at the first carbon, so it's called 1-pentene. What if we have the double bond is between the second and the third? Then it's going to be called 2-pentene. Can we have a 3-pentene? We draw it like this. No, it's not possible, since if we draw it like this, we start counting from the right side, and it's going to be called also 2-pentene, so it's not an isomer, since we have two structures with the same name, so they are not called isomers. So let me erase this one and start thinking of other possibilities, like what if we have 4 carbon atoms chain and 1 carbon is branched from that parent chain? And then can we place that branched carbon from the carbons that are located at the end of the parent chain like this? In this case, the longest chain is going to be like this, and it's going to be also 2-pentene like the above structures, so it's not an isomer. And we cannot place that branched carbon at the end of the parent chain. We have to think of the 2 carbons which are at the center, the second or the third one. So now let me draw them properly with the H's. The first one is going to be like this, and the second one is going to be like this. The name of the first structure is going to be 2-methyl-1-butene, while the name of the second one is going to be 3-methyl-1-butene. As I mentioned at the beginning, that you will find many useful links in the description that would help you how to name organic compounds. And now let's try to change the location of the double bond in that butene, like this. And since we cannot locate that branch at the end carbons, so we end up with two possibilities, either like this or like this. But in both cases, we will have the same name, because on the one on the left, we're going to start counting from the left side. On the one on the right, we're going to start counting from the right side. And in both cases, the methyl and the double bond are going to be at the same carbon, which is the second one. So let me erase these, and we'll end up with a structure like this. And its name is going to be 2-methyl-2-butene. And now let's think, can we draw a 3 atoms alkene like this with 2 branches? Since we cannot add the branches at the end carbons, and we have to add them at the center one, we cannot, since the carbon at the center will be joined to 5 carbon atoms, which is not possible. So let me erase it and go back to the general formula CnH2n, which I told you that it can be for alkene or it can be for cycloalkane. Cycloalkanes are carbon atoms that are joined with single covalent bonds, but they are forming a ring or a cycle. Like here we have 5 carbon atoms forming a cycle, so it's called cyclopentane. Or we can have a 4 carbon atoms ring like this, with 1 carbon branched, and it's called methyl cyclobutane. There is no need to locate the substituent since we have only 1 substituent. Another possibility with 2 carbon atoms chain joined to cyclopropane like this is going to be called ethyl cyclopropane. What if we have 2 methyl substituents joined to 2 different carbons in the cyclopropane? Here we should mention the location of these methyls, so the name is going to be 1,2-dimethyl cyclopropane. And the last isomer is going to be when we have 2 methyls joined to the same carbon in the cyclopropane, and its name is going to be 1,1-dimethyl cyclopropane. I think that these are all the possible isomers for C5H10. If you could have more, please write me a comment, and I hope that you like this video. And now you are ready to solve the end of video questions. Please, if you are not, repeat the video again Otherwise, solve the questions. Put your answer in the comments section. If you have any question that I didn't cover in the video, please share it with me in the comments section. Share this video with your friends. Subscribe to my channel to stay tuned for more videos. See you in other videos and good luck.